I'm going to read a few not so happy poems, and I apologize for that, but I don't know. A lot of things. I spend a lot of time thinking about the Shoa here in Estonia, and I spent a lot of time researching it the last week and all the months that I've been here in Estonia now. And I'm going to read some poems about that, but I also want to read another poem in German first that is about my former sailing teacher who died a few years ago. And yeah, because there has been another recent death close to me, I've been reminded of this poem, so I'm going to read it now. Okay. The poem is called Du im Wind. Es ist blau, überall, um mich herum. Es umgibt mich, es flimmert, es glitzert. Und ich sehe sie, die weißen Punkte. Sie sausen, flattern und dümpeln, klappern. Es zieht mich an, ich bin angezogen. Neoprenschuhe, Neoprenanzug, Neoprenhose, Schwimmweste für die Bewegungsfreiheit, Handschuhe für die Blasenfreiheit. So professionell und ganz schnell zu den Booten. Ich habe Schoten in den Händen und an der Pinne, den Ausleger natürlich. Und ich spüre wieder die Wellen, die Böen, die Strömung, das Boot, den Trim, meinen Körper. Und ich dazwischen, mittendrin, bewege mich, wende, halse, fast automatisch, fast natürlich. Bestimmt falsch, bestimmt zu wenig, bestimmt zu viel. Kann es nicht richtig, mach es nicht richtig, weiß es nicht richtig. Muss mehr trainieren, aber ich bin zufrieden, weil ich mich richtig fühle. Alles wegen dir, weil du es mir gezeigt hast. Wie bewegen, wie genießen, wie gewinnen, wie verlieren, wie segeln, wie leben. Du hast mich ermuntert, mir die Technik gegeben, die Kraft, den Mut und die Angst genommen. Vor Wind, vor Wellen, vor Böen, vor dem Kentern. Deshalb bist du bei mir, jedes Mal, wenn ich segel. Ich würde dir gerne sagen, was das heißt, wer ich jetzt bin, deswegen. Dass ich noch immer gebannt bin von Wind, Wasser, Wellen. Doch du bist gekentert und kannst dich nicht mehr aufrichten. Aber ich, wir alle stehen noch, ziehen die Schoten dicht und segeln weiter, leben weiter mit dir an Bord. Okay, thank you. Okay, the next poem I'm going to read is not my poem. It has been written by some unknown person, some prisoner of the Kluga concentration camp, and the poem has been found with the remains of the concentration camp and was in Russian. It has been translated to English, and you can find the poem in the Estonian Jewish Museum here in Tallinn. And it's not complete, so maybe it sounds strange at some points, but I really wanted to read it. We fall like autumn leaves from a strong wind. We lay like ears of corn at the foot of a harvest stand. We dry up like petrol on wooden trodden roads. We wither like grass in the heat, craving the rain. It happens that a tree falls with branches, roots protruding into the air like broken legs. A shaken Jew with frozen eyes lies bloated from hunger, stretched out on the ground. We extinguish there like candles. No one mourns the orphan with the funeral wail. One after another die, we set like stars in the morning sky. No one remains to speak, so that all might know of our great sorrow. Okay, so on the last poem is by me again, and I wrote it before I went to see all of those memorial sites, but I felt like it is really strange the way that the Holocaust and the Wehrmacht is seen here in Estonia, and that's what I wrote the poem about. It's called All Quiet on the Eastern Front. Tens of millions dead, displaced, destroyed. When they are gone, they leave a void. Those who remain just stare in trance, thanks to the rapid German advance. And the front is closing in on the people of Russia who don't want to flee. They don't have weapons in their command. It's only peace that they demand. Within the expansion of Lebensraum, the German soldiers don't care for a town. But so the people die through their arms, thanks to the rapid German advance. Estonia is free, Estonia is clear. No Jews, no Sinti, no Roma here. None of the commies destroying the land. None of the queers to walk hand in hand. It happens to be that they had no chance, thanks to the rapid German advance. Today, though, it seems no war is near. Open your eyes, the peace is here. It's quiet, just screams from afar. But in a museum on Saaremaa, there is it again, but from a positive stance, thanks to the rapid German advance.